Good afternoon, Emmanuel Elementary. God is good all the time. Well, welcome to another chapel. I hope you guys had a wonderful week. Can you believe we just have a week and a half left of school? That's amazing. Well, we're ready to worship together today, that's for sure. Our second graders had been preparing for their chapel before we left and went into schooling from home. So they've spent a little time preparing something virtual and very special for you. So I'm excited for this chapel and for our second graders to share. Let me pray for us, and then I'm going to turn it over to Mrs. Angelo and Mrs. Gutierrez. Okay, will you bow with me? Heavenly Father, thanks for another week. Thanks for more opportunities to learn about you. Thank you for our second graders who have shared their heart. Lord, I just ask that you teach us something new about yourself as we listen to chapel today. Just bless our time in your precious name. Amen. Okay, here's Mrs. Angelo and Mrs. Gutierrez. Enjoy chapel, guys.
Hi, this is Mrs. Angelo.
And Mrs. Gutierrez. Welcome to second grade chapel.
We weren't able to have chapel on campus, so we're coming to you virtually.
Enjoy our second grade chapel.
Today we live, today we breathe, today we know that we are strong when we are weak. Today we trust, we overcome, take every chain that kept us slaves and throw them off. We're not waiting for permission, we defy our inhibition, like our middle name is fearless.
Commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid. Do not be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
Joshua 1:9. 2 Timothy 1:7. For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and a calm mind.
Hi, my name is Avery, and God has changed my life during quarantine. I'm spending way more time with my family. It's great. We play lots of things. I am still seeing my friends on Zoom, and that's great. I also am spending so much time with my little brother. It's awesome. I'm getting so much time to focus on schoolwork every day. That's how God has changed my life during quarantine.
May the God of hope fill you with all joy.
And peace as you trust in Him. Romans 15:13.
Listen our confident hope. Be patient in trouble. And keep on praying. Romans 12:12.
Hi, I am Tanner Schmoll, and this is my paragraph about what I've learned this school year. What I've learned this school year is God makes us do things we don't expect. That when we see them, we think it will be a disaster. But if we believe in Him, it won't be a disaster. For example, when we had to leave school, if you believe in Him, He will have good plans for you in the future. And it did turn out okay, and we're still learning. And we get to see our friends and teachers.
The house is so simple, faith like a child. I give you an inch and you take me a mile. I feel the wind rush and the thunder roll. 2 feet on the water, only one way to go. Yeah. I don't gotta be afraid no more. Cause I know you up through the storm. I'm more than just a talker. I'm a wave walker. I'm dancing on water. When the devil tries to shake me, I'll just pray harder. Even in my darkest hour, I got Holy Ghost power. When I keep my eyes upon you, Jesus, I'm a wave walker. Now. I don't gotta be afraid no more, cause I know you're up and through the storm. I'm more than just a talker, I'm a wave rocker. I'm a wave rocker, I'm dancing on water. When the devil tries to shake me, I just pray harder. Even in my darkest hour, I got Holy Ghost power. When I keep my eyes upon you, Jesus, I'm a wave rocker. Wave rocker, oh, 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 don't you hear me now?
Be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or do not be discouraged, for the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go.
For God has not given us a spirit of fear, but of power and of love and of a sound mind. 2 Timothy 1:17.
I've been volunteering with Fresno Wildlife a lot this year, and I realize it is important to take good care of God's creatures. Stewardship means serving God through time, talent, or treasure. I consider volunteering with Fresno Wildlife a way of serving God with my time and talent. I have helped take care of many opossums, owls, and a hawk this year. Fresno Wildlife believes native wildlife deserves a second chance, just like Jesus gives us a second chance when he forgives our sins. 1 Peter 4:10 says, each of you should use whatever gift you have received to serve others as faithful stewards for God's grace in its many forms. In closing, I would like to read a poem by Cecil Frances Alexander. All things bright and beautiful, all creatures great and small, all things wise and wonderful, the Lord God made them all. I would encourage you to find a way to serve God through your time, talent, or treasure.
Rejoice in our confident hope.
Be patient in trouble and keep on praying. Romans 12:12.
Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be afraid or discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. Joshua 1:9.
Hi, I'm Grace. This school year, God has been teaching me not to be afraid because he is always with me. Sometimes I get a little worried or afraid of certain things, like staying healthy or being safe in our house at night, or even learning to ride my bike. It reminds me of Isaiah 41:10. I should not fear because God is with me. I will not be dismayed because he is my Lord. He will strengthen me, he will help me, and he will uphold me with his righteous right hand. So just remember, the Lord is with you and would do anything to protect you and anything to help you. Bye, thanks for watching. And don't forget, be bold.
This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. This light of mine, I'm gonna let it shine. Let it shine, let it shine, let it shine. Thank you.
second graders. What an awesome chapel. I loved all the scripture you guys shared. Did you guys hear all those scriptures? Reminders to rejoice in hope, be patient in trouble, be strong and courageous, have no fear, keep on praying. Man, those are words straight from the Lord, straight from the Bible. So thank you guys for sharing those. And then did you hear from four of our fourth graders who shared how the Lord has been working on their hearts during their time at home? So did you hear what Avery said? She was sharing about how the one thing she's really learned, and it's just been really different, is how much time she's had with her family. And I loved how she said she's even had a lot of really special time with her brother. So I hope you guys have felt that too. Even though we're not with our friends, this whole time has given us more time with our family, which is really special. And I know a lot of you have shared that that's been fun. You guys have maybe started some new traditions together. So thank you for that reminder, Avery. And then Tanner, he kind of reminded us a little bit of what Mrs. R had talked about, how things sometimes happen that are unexpected, right? He said, God has us do things we don't expect, but he has good plans for us. I love that reminder, Tanner, because we all experience that. Something comes unexpected. Huh, I have to stop and think, the Lord's got a plan in this. I know I can trust him. So we need to look for that good plan, maybe in the unexpected, huh? So thanks, Tanner. Loved that. And then Alyssa, she was sharing about something that she does. She volunteers, right? And she told us kind of a big word called stewardship, which means using your time, talents, and treasures, right, to help, to use what the Lord's given you to maybe go out and serve. And I know a lot of you have taken advantage of that. You've spread joy with our Student Council Challenge. You've served your families and your communities. So I love that reminder, Alyssa, of how we can use our time and talent. That's what she was talking about, to serve others and to make a difference. Great reminder. And then Grace wrapped it up, right, with our theme for the year. She said she has learned, man, she struggled a little bit with fear, but she's learned she doesn't have to be afraid because God is always with us. I loved that ending because that's perfect. That's what we've been talking about all year, huh? And then she even showed us our theme, and we haven't done our hand motions for a while. So she just showed you, think you guys can do it with me? Remember, be bold. Let's try it. Be bold. Whatever you guys choose for bold, huh? Okay, what a great time together. I am so proud of our second graders. Thanks for worshiping with us today. We do have a few more second graders that wanted to share at the end now, and they're gonna tell you what is so special to them about Emmanuel. So please tune in, watch the rest of this, and enjoy their hearts as they share why Emmanuel's so special. Maybe then you can think, what during this time has the Lord taught me? And what do I love so much about my Emmanuel family? And then we can head into our weekend thinking about those awesome things. Okay, you guys have a wonderful time. Hey, one reminder, if you're interested in talent show, you have until Monday at 5 o'clock to get that posted into Schoology, okay? And then we have to put it together and make the talent show video that will go live on Wednesday at 1. Okay, I'll remind you of that, but maybe you can work on that this weekend. Hopefully you'll have a little free time. Enjoy, grab your mom, grab your dad, grab your siblings. They might have talents too. Okay, have some fun with it, and we'll see you next week, guys. Love ya, bye-bye.
I love Emmanuel. I love that Emmanuel has great teachers that I love. I also love Emmanuel because I get to learn with my friends. And I love that our symbol is a bald eagle. Emmanuel is the best school ever.
Hi, my name is Nolan, and I'm in second grade, Skateras class. Emmanuel has meant a lot to me this year because I made really good friends, and I have a really awesome teacher. I also went on a really awesome train for a field trip. I feel so blessed to pray at school and be able to learn about God.
My first year at Emmanuel has been lots of fun. We learn a lot about God. We pray every morning with the flag and have chapel on Fridays. Chapel is fun because we sing Christian songs and dance. Mrs. Garrett and all the Emmanuel staff are really nice. I have had a lot of fun making new friends at Emmanuel.
Emmanuel to me means having great friends, teacher, and staff that feel like family. Emmanuel provides me with knowledge and confidence to live out my faith and walk daily with Jesus. Emmanuel set a great example for us students in how to handle the coronavirus pandemic, teaching me how to be strong and courageous when times get tough. Emmanuel has shown me this year that it has never been more important to be bold in my faith.